You're listening to the sounds of Salford from the UK going out to the world.
I'm a gonna raise a fuss, I'm a gonna raise a holler about a working all summer just to try to earn a dollar. Every time I call my baby, try to get a date, my boss says,
"No die, son, you gotta work late."
Sometimes I wonder what I'm gonna do, but there ain't no cure for the summertime blues. Oh, well, my mom and papa told me, son, you gotta make some money. If you want to use a car to go a ride next Sunday. Oh, well, I didn't go to work, told the boss I was sick.
Now you can't use a car cause you didn't work or live.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm gonna do, but there ain't no cure for the summertime blues. I'm gonna take 2 weeks, gonna have a fine vacation. I'm gonna take my problem to the United Nations. Well, I called my congressman and he said, quote,
"I'd like to help you, son, but you're too young to vote."
Sometimes I wonder what I'm gonna do, but there ain't no cure for the summertime blues.
Welcome to the Golden Girls, apart from this, just the Golden Girl today, isn't it, mate?
He says, our Noreen, we're saying good luck to Noreen, she's having a treatment, so we miss you, Noreen.
We're missing you like mad mate, it's not the same without you, but you know what, you're in our thoughts, girl, that's all we can say, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
So, yeah. You know.
So today we're doing, this was what Noreen and somebody else chose, Eddie Cochran.
Yes, Eddie Cochran, that was Summertime Blues, wasn't it, kicking the show off.
Yeah, fabulous. So we're going to play some of his music and talk about him.
Yes.
So
here we go, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, and we talk about his early life. He was called Edward Raymond Cochran, and he was born on October the 3rd, 1938, in Albert Lea, Minnesota, to parents Alice and Frank Cochran. His parents were from Oklahoma, and he also always said in his interviews that his parents had some roots in Oklahoma. He took music lessons in school but quit the band to play drums. Also, rather than taking piano lessons, he began learning guitar, playing country and other music he heard on the radio. And in his early career, from 1952 to 1956, Cochran's family moved to Bell Gardens, California in 1952. As his guitar playing improved, he formed a band with two friends from his junior high school. He dropped out of Bell Garden High School in the first year to become a professional musician. During a show featuring many performers at an American Legion Hall, he met Hank Cochran, a songwriter, although they were not related. They recorded as the Cochran Brothers and began performing together. They recorded a few singles on Echo then that were fairly successful and helped to establish them as a performing act. Eddie Cochran also worked as a session musician and began writing songs, making a demo with Jerry Capehart, his future manager. In July 1955, Eddie Cochran's first solo artist single was released on the Christabel. It featured Skinny Jim, now regarded as a rock and roll and rockabilly classic, in the spring of 1956. Boris Petrov asked Cochran if he would appear in the musical comedy film The Girl Can't Help It. Cochran agreed and performed the song 20 Flight Rock in the movie.
On that note, I think we'll go to a special request, eh?
And yes.
First one lines up. It's lined up for Deb Clemens, isn't it?
Yeah, for our Deb. Yeah.
Our Deb. It's a great song, this one.
It is.
As well.
It's brilliant, this.
can put together tonight. I got some money in my jeans and I'm really gonna spend them right. Well, I've been doing my homework all the week along, and now the house is empty and my folks have gone. Woo, come on everybody. Number one, but I'm gonna dance with three or four. And the house will be a shaking from the bare feet, a slapping on the floor. Well, when you hear the music, you just can't sit still. If your brother won't rock, then your sister will. Woo, come on, everybody. Come on, everybody!
Come on, everybody, going out there to the lovely Demi Clemens.
Yeah, great song. Great lady too.
Yes.
So later on in his career, in 1957-1959, Cochran starred in his second film, Untamed Youth, and he had yet another hit, Sitting in the Balcony. That's the name of the song. One of the few songs he recorded that was written by other songwriters. 20 Flight Rock was written by AMI staff writer Ned Fairchild, who was not a rock and roll performer, merely provided the initial form of the song. The co-writing credit reflects Cochran's major changes and contributions to the final product. In February 1957, Liberty Records released Cochran's only studio album released during his lifetime, called Singing to My Baby. The album including Sitting in the Balcony. There were also a few rockers on this album, and Liberty seemed to want to move Cochran in a different musical direction, but Cochran refused. In 1957, however, Cochran seemed to find his stride in the famous teenage anthem, Summertime Blues, written by Jerry Capehart. With this song, Cochran was established as one of the most important influences on rock and roll music in the 1950s, both lyrically and musically. He had other hits, Come On Everybody, Something Else, Teenage Heaven, and his posthumous UK number one hit, Three Steps to Heaven. Eddie Cochran remained popular in the US and UK throughout the late 1950s and early 1960s, and scored more posthumous hits such as My Way, Weekend, and Nervous Breakdown.
And on that note, I think we'll go to Something Else, eh? That's a great something song, this else, one, isn't it? Yeah. She's Something Else.
Oh, look at there. Here she comes.
Here comes that girl again. Wanted to be her since I don't know when. She don't notice me when I pass. She pulls with older guys from out of my class. But can't he stop me from thinking to myself?
She's your fine looking man. She's something else. Across the street.
There's a car made just for me. To own that car would be a luxury. But right now I can't afford the gas. A brand new convertible is out of my class. But that thing's got me from a thinking to myself.
That car's fine looking, man. Get something else. Hey, look at here. Just wait and see.
Get me that girl and we'll go riding around. We'll go to the real shop with a white top down. I keep my own a dreaming and I'm thinking to myself.
It all comes true, man. Wow, that's something else.
what's all this?
Never thought I'd do this before, but here I am, I'm knocking on the door. My car's out front, if it's all mine, just a 41 Ford, not a 59. I got that girl and I'm a-thinking to myself,
she's sure fine looking, man, wow, she's something else.
Something else going out there to our Noreen, because she really is something else, isn't she, mate? Right, I want to mention this, if you don't mind me butting in.
Yes.
Right, there's a Rendezvous Circle of Buddy Singles, and it is opening at a new venue, and that is the Ellesmere Sports Club on Walkden Road, Worsley. The postcode is M282RZ, and guess what? For all these single women, it is next to the Cock Hotel. Right, it's the Ellesmere Sports Club next to the Cock. If you're a single lady and you know where the Cock is,
yeah.
Well, it's just next door to there, isn't it? It starts on Wednesday, the 26th of October, and it's 8 till 12 o'clock. It's only £3 on the door.
Yes.
So £3 is not bad, is it?
It's very good.
For that, you get a disco, you get everything, do you know what I mean?
You get everything. There's a car park.
There's even a bit of an happy hour, isn't there, where they're going to reduce the prices between 8 and 9.
Yeah, well, they're actually going to do it throughout the night. They're going to reduce them.
Right, so it gets even better, this. So if you're a single lady...
And a man.
And you're looking for somewhere to go on a Wednesday night, make sure you go to the Ellesmere Sports Club, right? For more information, you can phone this number. It's 0161... 790-2376, or you can phone this mobile. I don't know whose it is. Whose is it? Oh, right. Oh, my God. We've just got into the song, but I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to move the song out of the way. Right? See what happened there? That is a magic radio. I'm sorry, right away over it. Or it's 075-909-79-645, and that is a lovely. Normal. So everyone's welcome. You can come along, you can put your dancing shoes on, and you can meet new people, you can listen to great music, but most of all, you can enjoy yourself.
Yes.
What's on a Wednesday night? Coronation Street. Right, don't watch Coronation Street. Get to the new Ellesmere Sports Club. It's a singles night. It's also known as a bit of a swingers night. Well, it's not really, but...
It's not. But it's a group that's been going for a while, and we're looking for new members. So come and enjoy yourself.
Yeah,
we'll have a great time.
Get along there. Have a good night. That's what we say here on the Sounds of Salford, don't we?
Yeah, we do.
Right, let's get back on with the show.
So we'll get back on to Eddie. Another aspect of Eddie's short but brilliant career is his work as backup musician and producer. He played guitar on tracks by Ray Stanley, Lee Denson, Baker Knight, Bob Denton, Galen Dennett, Don Deal, Troy Key, Mike Clifford, Paula Morgan, Jody Reynolds, Johnny Burnett, and loads more I won't go into. In 1959, he played lead for Skeets MacDonald at Columbia Studios for You Ought to See Grandma Rock and Heartbreaking Mama. In a session for Gene Vincent in 1958, he contributed his trademark low bass voice, as heard on Summertime Blues. The recording was issued on the album at Gene Vincent record date. In early 1959, two of Cochran's friends, Buddy Holly and Ricky Valens, along with the Big Bopper, were killed in a plane crash while on tour. Eddie's friends and family later said that he was badly shaken by their deaths, and he developed a morbid premonition that he also would die young. It was shortly after their deaths that he wrote and recorded a tribute to them all called Three Stars. He was anxious to give up life on the road and spend his time in the studio making music, thereby reducing the chance of suffering a similar fatal accident while touring. Financial responsibilities, however, required that he continue to perform live, and that led to his acceptance of an offer to tour in the United Kingdom in 1960.
On that note, I think we'll go to a song here, a bit of 20 Flight Rock.
This is you going up your stairs.
Ooh, I'll see.